For many rockhounds, an ultraviolet light is an invaluable tool. This light is something extra special. Designed by flashlight and mineralogy enthusiast Raymond Wu, the FWOD combines three carefully selected high-power ultraviolet emitters with different wavelengths into a well-designed and highly functional package. This goes far beyond a normal ultraviolet light into territory reserved for very specific niche applications. Now, as usual, this video is based on my own testing and opinions, but I was paid to showcase this light. Raymond wanted my objective thoughts and feedback, which I am still claiming to provide, but be aware of the potential bias. Notably, I do not have a specific need for ultraviolet lights. They are really more of a novelty to me, and I find this one especially fascinating. The ISO standard categorizes ultraviolet light into three groups, which includes longwave, or UVA, mediumwave, or UVB, and shortwave, or UVC, bands. Longwave UV light includes the familiar black light wavelengths used to light up parties and for inspection of various materials. Medium and shortwave emitters are much less common, only being found in very specialized applications. The FWOD was designed specifically for the hunting, identification, and display of fluorescent mineral groups. This is accomplished by mixing the different emission sources to separate out specific minerals. Many minerals will fluoresce under ultraviolet light, but some are reactive only to a small range of wavelengths that fall beyond the UVA bands. By combining all three bands, longwave, midwave, and shortwave, this flashlight makes it easy to hunt and identify specific minerals. As an example, this mineral sample contains calcite, which glows bright orange under the shortwave light, and sphalerite, which glows purple under the longer waves. This light allows the two to fluoresce separately or at varying levels together. Meanwhile, this sample of fluorite will fluoresce under longwave light, but doesn't react strongly to the other bands, while this bonitoite crystal suddenly jumps into view under the shortwave light. Similarly, this chalcedony glows a lime green only under the shortwave light, an effect that is simply impossible to achieve without an emitter that can produce these specific wavelengths. And, of course, there are many minerals which glow only under the longwave light as well, such as these samples of sodalite, scapolite, and prehnite. Safety is important with this light as it emits high energy waves of the type normally blocked by the Earth's ozone. In particular, the high power UVC light plants this into the category of cancer ray. The beam should not be shined on exposed skin, and eye protection is required when operating this light. Nothing fancy is needed. Simple polycarbonate safety glasses are enough to block the harmful rays. Selecting the desired channels is very easy with the three buttons arrayed on the head, arranged from left to right by wavelength, which is the main standout design feature of this device. The buttons are brightly lit green on standby and switch to red when active, a clear and effective indication. A simple press will turn the channel on or off. The longwave channel allows for output ramping with the press and hold of the button. I did find it tricky to dial in the right brightness at the lowest ends of the ramp, and I wish the light would stop and clearly blink at the end of the ramp instead of immediately reversing direction again. When in use, the buttons will only glow for a few seconds before turning off. The three buttons are also used to indicate battery levels once plugged in via the USB-C port. Three separate channels in the driver provide independent power for their respective emitters, with the medium and shortwave channels producing 100 milliwatts per channel, and the longwave channel getting up to 2000 milliwatts at its maximum level. At the highest output level, the longwave channel runs for about 315 minutes total, gradually falling in output to about 75% before dying out. Unfortunately, output isn't totally flat over the runtime, but the drop is not too large. The medium and shortwave channel run for just a few minutes longer, despite being much lower in output. This is a large amount of UV light, and when combined with the tightly focused reflectors, each channel is capable of exciting fluorescent materials at a pretty impressive distance. It's not the most powerful UV light I've used, but it's more than enough for honestly anything I could think to use it for. It's a very capable light. The emitters are situated on top of a thick copper MCPCB for better heat dissipation, and sit under a large aluminum reflector with three separate wells that each provide a very clean beam pattern. At the front of the light is a dichroic lens that blocks the visible light emitted by the LEDs. A filter like this greatly improves the usefulness of a UV flashlight, as it prevents fluorescing materials from being washed out in visible wavelength violet light. When compared to a similarly powered longwave light that lacks this feature, the increase in contrast is quite significant. Dichroic lenses can allow over 90% UV light transmission, much better than other filter types used in flashlights, but they do come at a higher cost. This light is designed to take a 32650 battery, which matches the 32mm driver and prevents the difficulties of mixing multiple lithium-ion cells. However, Raymond tells me that he couldn't find a reliable enough 32mm cell, so only a 21700 is slated to be included. Also included are 3D printed tubes for adapting different battery widths. It's hard for me to note the downsides, as someone who only uses a light like this for its novelty value. The light has a pretty simple task to perform, and it does so without apparent issue. There is a large difference in power levels between the longwave channel and the other two, but it can be balanced out pretty easily. However, the ramping of the longwave channel is the light's biggest flaw, in my opinion. I wish there was a way to jump to either extreme, perhaps with a quick double tap, and I wish there was a standard blink to indicate when you've reached the end of the ramp before it begins to reverse direction. As it stands, it can be annoying to set it to the highest or lowest levels. Because the emitters each possess their own reflector well, the hotspots of the beams don't perfectly overlap each other, which is especially noticeable, really only noticeable, at close range. This is something to note if you're using the light for mineral display. And, though obvious, it's still worth noting that this device doesn't really produce light in the visible spectrum, so it's still necessary to carry along a standard flashlight. Finally, I want to repeat this note on safety. This is a very powerful flashlight, and the high energy wavelengths emitted are particularly dangerous. The UVB and especially UVC channels are quite hazardous, with the latter capable of sterilizing surfaces and bearing the nickname of cancer ray. Avoid pointing the beam at bare skin and always wear eye protection while operating these lights. Simple and inexpensive polycarbonate lenses, such as standard safety glasses, are sufficient to block these harmful rays. Overall, this is an impressive and well thought out device that is very effective for its intended use case. I found it to be actually quite intuitive and quite easy to use, and it did help me actually find real mineral samples in the field, so I was quite happy with it. At $375, it's pretty expensive, but it represents great value for a low volume specialty light with exotic emitters. The expertly configured feature set and simple usability makes for an easy recommendation to its niche audience. That being said, the audience for this light certainly is niche. It's the kind of product where if you have to ask what it's useful for, it's probably not for you. If you do have a use for it though, I think you'll be really happy with it. Well, that's all for this review. Again, this was a sponsored video, but it's one that I agreed to because the light just looked so cool to me. I'm not aware of anything else like it, and it occupies a very special place in my collection. If you might have some other unique use case for this light, let me know in the comments below. I'd be really interested to hear. In the meantime, if you want a flashlight that's actually designed to help you see what you're doing in the dark, I've reviewed a few of those as well, so feel free to check those videos out. And thanks for watching.